Hello, unsurprisingly, these are the components for my jelly 2x2. The first task was to remove the outer shell of the 2x2 in preparation for the later casting. In order to make the jelly extensions to the 2x2, I had to make a mould. And in order to make a mould, I had to make a master. As with the floppy cube, I put one of the parts into the master, so the mold, it kind of like it will mold the whole thing, so when I come to casting it in jelly, it will be similar to this with the floppy cube. It will be sort of attached right into it, because you obviously aren't going to be able to glue jelly. I used recesses the same as with the floppy cube, and that so I can color the different sides. Right, so here is the mould. Now I can explain a little bit more about what exactly I'm doing. So by putting a milliput there, it's created a gap there. So when I put this in, there's going to be a gap underneath that. And then when I pour the jelly in, some of the jelly is going to go in that hole and it's going to like be underneath there. So it's effectively giving it a way of holding it into place. And that's also why I've got these little ridges in there. I'm going to show you the push trip in. Obviously, you can't really see it very clearly. But now the jelly has got something to hold on to. So you may be wondering why I got 4 green and 4 orange and not just 8 black. Well, I did an experiment with black earlier, and this is black currant, and it actually came out quite good. But it just doesn't really look like jelly to me. And you know, the whole point of this is like for a video, and whereas this is definitely has a jelly look to it, I don't think this does. And also, when I came to colour it, I added red into this recess, and the red, because it's kind of like translucent, you just see through it and you see the black underneath. So the colouring is kind of impossible. Having said that though, I then experimented with actually painting the recesses white. And then when I added a colour, it wasn't too bad. So here I've got the green, for example. And I did another little experiment there with the orange. So in theory, I could use black and colour it like that. But I still just feel it doesn't really look like jelly enough to me. So I thought, right, I'll go for green and orange. And the reason for the two colours is because there just aren't that many colours available to me. And this is going to mean that I can put green into the orange recesses and I can put orange into the green recesses. So that gives me two colours. I can also use this black for one side. I can also use a red. And I'm not quite sure yet how I'm going to do the others. I might just double up.
Okay, so this is where things started to go wrong. Each cubie weighs over 400 grams and they were just sliding away from the core. So I took it apart and assembled it again, but this time gluing them into place. However, I got some glue inside the core, making the puzzle impossible to turn. I also found that the water I'd used as lube was making the jelly separate from the plastic. The small holes I had drilled were nowhere near big enough to keep the jelly attached. So unfortunately, I had to cast all the jelly parts again. This time I attached large milliput loops onto the plastic cubies, and that held the jelly securely into place. I was also far more careful with the gluing. Finally, I got a puzzle that should work. Here it is, fully lubed with lots of water, which makes it slippery as hell. At 3.5 kilograms, it's also very heavy to hold, especially at arm's length for the camera. When I made the new pieces, I used a slightly different color scheme. My previous one was not so good, as the raspberry and strawberry colors were too close to tell apart. I'm now using just lime, orange, strawberry, and blackcurrant. I will let you enjoy the rest of my solve.